in here.
And the bass keeps running, running, and 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 running, running, and
in this context, there's no disrespect. So when I bust my rhyme, you break your necks. We got 5 minutes for us to disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect. The inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out, girl is pulling me out. You wouldn't believe how we wow shit out. We burn it till it's burned out, turn it till it's turned out. Act up from northwest, east side. Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned, come on, get it started, come on, get it started, get it started. Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Yeah. Lose control, a body and soul. Don't move too fast, people just take it slow. Don't get ahead, just jump into it. Y'all hear about it? The P's will do it. Get started. Get stupid, don't worry about it. People will walk you through it step by step like an infant new kid. Inch by inch with a new solution. Transmit hits with no delusion. The feeling's irresistible and that's how we moving. Yo,
everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stupid,
come on,
get started,
come on,
get started,
yeah.
Get started.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Yeah.
Just keep running, running, and running, running.
Come on, y'all. Let's get it.
Deal. Applicator will bring the bugged out drill.
Just
lose your mind, this is the time. Your can't stand still, twist and bang your spine.
Just
bob your head like me, Apple D. Up inside your club or in your Bentley. Get messy, loud and sick. Your mind fast, no more on another head trip.
So
come down now, do not correct it. Let's get ignorant, let's get hectic.
Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned,
come on,
get started,
come on,
get started.
Get started. Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Let's get it started. Let's get it started
in here.
Yeah.
The dawning of our lives. She brings.
Hello and welcome to another edition of the Melrose Lady Red Raider Girls Varsity Hockey. Today the Lady Red Raiders face off against the Bishop Fenwick Lady Crusaders. So a couple of ladies going after ladies teams here. The Melrose girls come in with a record of 11-8. They've secured a spot in the postseason play. And the Fenwick Lady Crusaders are sitting at 7-11-2. Starting off in Melrose, we have Rachel DeFryer at center, Sasha Connolly on right wing, Sammy Kroon left wing, Gorman up through the neutral zone, can't connect with DeFryer. Darby Rich is out there, Kroon will send that back in. Connolly on the forecheck, can't get it out. Fenwick, Connolly can't control it. Back to Gorman, going back down low to Connolly. She slides it over to Kroon, nice pass in front. Can't connect with Rachel. Connolly, good hustle on the puck. Back to Gorman, she'll get that on net. Cross ice to Rich. Rich will shoot that, doesn't get on net. DeFryer tries to tap it. She's battling in the corner. Finds Connolly to Gorman. Good puck movement here to Darby. Get it on net. Sniper. Gorman can't handle it. Good job. Oh, Rich can't get it out. Murrow's pinned in there late into the first shift. Gorman's got to move that puck. You have Connolly open. Give her the puck. Can't have defensemen skating it out of the zone. Makes no sense to me. There comes Gorman. She'll break it out. No one on her. They'll get a line change. She'll dump that on net. Goalie Megan Woodward makes a save. Woodward's a Melrose girl. Opted to go to Bishop Fenwick. Bishop Fenwick also without their star player, Jill Matucci. It's out with a fractured clavicle. It's another Melrose girl. Here comes Julie McLaughlin streaking through the middle. Tries to make a shift. Can't on number 13. That's Allie Jaguar, a sophomore for Bishop Fenwick. There's Emma Sikora backhanding it low into the zone. Here comes Linnea Kelly on the forecheck. Melrose doing a good job thus far keeping it in the zone. There's Merce, a nice low shot. Woodward makes the save. Sammy Kroon steps up, can't keep it in. Takes the body nicely. Katy Perry out there with Jill Merce. Move the puck, Jill. Move the puck. Up to Connolly. Too late on that pass. Come on, girls, keep your head up. Let's pass this puck quicker. Very lethargic start on this early Sunday morning game. These girls really should be at church, but here they are. Bishop Fenwick must have given a special dispensation to play. Or maybe they went to Mass last night. Good move by Perry. Move that puck up to Connolly. Connolly will get that down deep. She'll change. Kroon on the forecheck along with DeFryer. Bad bounce. McLaughlin can't control it. Megan Carney coming through. She's a talented player there for Bishop Fenwick. She's a junior. Gorman gets it out to McLaughlin. Can't get it deep. Lauren Cucolotto, sophomore. She's on the puck. Nice save by a Melrose goalie, Courtney O'Connor. Sorry, that was Cucolotto, sophomore defenseman. Also out there is Allie Jaguar, sophomore defenseman. Jaguar keeps it in. Smartly goes down into the corner. There's Darby Rich on the puck. Doesn't get much grease on it. Melrose able to get it out. Melrose has to do a better job, the defenseman especially, of... We got it offsides here. Melrose has to do a better job defensively of moving that puck out of the zone. If the wings are on the board, you got to move that puck up to them. Get it to them. Don't think about it. First instinct should be Make that outlet pass. Get the puck out of the zone. We can't have defensemen carrying the puck out. You get pickpocketed in front, it's going to be bad things happening to you. Rachel Boylan, another sophomore for Bishop Fenwick on the puck. Bishop Fenwick's a young team. It's senior day here for the Bishop Fenwick Lady Crusaders. They aren't graduating a lot of seniors. I think it's just three seniors they're graduating, so they're a young team, much like Melrose. Melrose is graduating four seniors. There's the Hatchet Sakura on the puck. Here comes Chelsea Kelly. It's a foot race. Beats her opponent. Uses the body. Emma Penault out there for Melrose. Bishop Fenwick able to get it out. Mercer on the puck. She'll circle it up. Look to make a pass. Michelle Henry's out there. Come on, Jill, make a pass. There you go. Get it deep now. It's Kellyanne on the slap shot. Doesn't get anything on it. A rolling puck. Michelle Henry on the backhand, and Woodward able to corral that puck. That's a dangerous puck. It's bouncing. It's like a knuckleball. Michelle Henry on the faceoff. She'll have Emma Penault. Kellyanne Kendall. Alyssa Gorman on D with Dobby. It's nice to be rich. Bishop Fenwick controls. Nice play by their defender. Got a step up. Nice save by Courtney O'Connor. Kicks it into the corner. Outlet pass from Penault to Henry. Can't connect. Lauren Cucaludo. Or Cocaludo brings it in. Around the boards to Penault. She's just going to ice it. Melrose will live to fight another day. So far, Melrose hasn't done anything. Their passing hasn't been good. They haven't broken out of the defensive zone all that well. They need to slow it down when they get it in the offensive zone. Create some more passing. Mercer on the puck around the net. Makes a cut to the middle. Should be away with the race. To the races here. Let's get open, girls. Let's take that shot. Nice shot. Follow up. Connolly can't get it. And it's in. It's in. We're going to get Connolly crashing that net. After Mercer made a nice rush up ice. That's what you want to see. Want to see the girls crash a net. So with 8:38 to go in the period, Melrose will take a 1-0 lead. Kellyanne Kendall on the forecheck, lifts the stick up nicely. Here comes Chelsea Kelly on the follow-up. McLaughlin's out there digging hard. Around the boards, can't get it out. Mercer tries to get that deep, can't. Good job riding that number 15. Lexi McNeil, a freshman off the puck. Here's big Rachel Boylan, sophomore. Mercer backhands it over to Katie Perry. Not that Katie Perry. NTKP over to Mercer. She'll look to make a pass. Can't connect with Sakura. Woodworth will tie that up. Get a face-off. We've got a face-off in the offensive zone. 7:42 to go in the first period. Melrose up 1-0. Megan Woodworth in goal for Bishop Fenwick. She's an excellent goalie. Knows how to take up a lot of space in net. Melrose really has to crash the net to get goals. She's not going to give up easy goals, that's for sure. Michelle Henry keeping it deep. Kellyanne Kendall on the puck. Good hustle there by Michelle Henry. Gets ridden off the puck. Dobby, it's nice to be rich. We'll fire that back in. Melrose tags up, all on sides. Gorman does a great job of pinching in like she's been doing all year. Here comes Rich trying to keep it in and does. Gets it down deep. This is what Melrose wants to do. Keep it in the offensive zone. Keep the pressure on. Maybe you get a line change while the puck's in the offensive zone and your opponent can't. So they're going to be dog tired. Rich tries to get it deep. Can't. Bishop Fenwick's able to get it out. Here's Gorman. All clear. Tries to chip it past. Got away with one there. Nice little cross check by Alyssa. Don't call me Haley. Dobby Rich on the puck. She'll cycle that around. Can't connect with Crone. Crone doesn't get her stick on it, though. Rich can't connect with Crone. Gorman on the puck. Centers it to DeFryer. Nice cross-ice pass to Crone. Crone's coming in. Connolly's going to break to the net. All alone. Crone can't get it. Saw it. Couldn't get it there. This is what they need. Puck movement. Good job by Melrose on that puck. Mercer pinching in. Doing a good job there. Bringing it around. Keeping it on her stick. Make a pass. Don't just get rid of it. A lot of battling going on out there. Perry doing a great job of coming down, keeping the puck in. That's what Melrose needs to do. Nice shift there by number 21, Lauren Coccoluto. NTKP on the puck. She angles it to Mercer. Make a pass, Jill. Not that pass. We're taking too long to make these passes. Here's McLaughlin. Can't get it by number 16. Gabby Dottolo, senior. Here's a nice pass from Perry to McLaughlin. Take that shot. Nice move by Julia. Nice save, and the net's crashed there by the hacksaw. She just couldn't get it in. That was a nice move by McLaughlin. Juked that player right out of her skates. She might have broken an ankle. Here's a hacksaw, tries the backhand pass. Rich can't keep it in. Linnea Kelly will make a nice move, go around two opponents. She's looking to make a pass. Melrose getting a line change. Kelly, the hacksaw has the puck, centers it, couldn't connect. Melrose doing a good job of forechecking. Gorman keeps that in on the backhand. Melrose getting a line change. Gorman will keep that on her stick. Doing an excellent job of keeping it. Winds out. Here comes the pass to pass out to Emma Penault. It looked like it was tipped on the way through. Great puck movement there by Melrose. Good job by Alyssa, don't call me Haley, Gorman, controlling that puck behind the net. Like I've been saying all year, don't just get rid of the puck to get rid of it. Look to make a pass, and that's exactly what she did. So with 3:33 to go in the first, Melrose will take a 2-0 lead. Backhand Perry up to Kellyanne Kendall. Has to keep her head up. Michelle Henry breaking through the neutral zone into the offensive zone. Comes a speedy number 21 for the Lady Crusaders, Coccoluto. Coccoluto's a sophomore. Here comes Crone. Cross pass to DeFryer. Nice pass to Connolly. Can't connect. Connolly will get it back. Centers it. Good job by Megan Carney for Bishop Fenwick coming in and breaking up DeFryer. DeFryer couldn't get her stick on it. Mercer's going to move that puck up ice. Another bad pass there. You got to see the opponent coming in. Come on, Jill. Wake up a little here. Let's go. Nice pass to Connolly. Connolly can't get it by number 16, Gabby Dotolo. Melrose defense has to do a better job of making quicker passes in the defensive zone. They're taking way too long in the telegraphing where the passes are going to go. Come on, Dobby, get rid of it. There you go. Nice pass. Good job keeping that in. Here's Julia McLaughlin. Number 16, the captain. Dotolo can't get it out. Aggressive forecheck by Melrose. Gorman keeps it on, keeps it in, shoots it towards the net. Rich will do the same thing. She keeps it deep. Keep it on your stick. She gives it to the hacksaw. Gorman's doing a great job all year, coming down the boards, keeping that puck in. Look at her, behind the net. We got Linnea Kelly there taking over her position. Let's fire that right back in. Let's fire that right back in. Nice shift there by Chelsea Kelly. Oh, well, we're going to get a penalty on that one. That's a good call there. Probably get an interference on that. Well, I got a trip. Okay. So the senior, Captain Gabby Dotolo, goes to the box for a minute and a half with 1:09 left in the first period. Power play unit of Smiley DeFryer, Julia McLaughlin, Sammy Kroon, Muggsy Connolly, and Jill Mercer. See what they can do. They control the draw. Mercer to Connolly. Over to DeFryer. To Mercer. Mercer lets go. Loose in front. That was not a good shot. Got to move the puck more, girls. Got to move the puck more. Don't just take it because you have it. Mercer moves it up to Connolly, up to McLaughlin. She'll carry it in. Stops. Let's control that puck now. Over to Connolly. One-timer. Hits someone coming through. Bouncing puck. Who's going to get it? There's the Fryer on her stick. Tries to center it. Can't. Good clear by number 15, Lexi McNeil, a freshman. 23 seconds to go in the period. Connolly has the puck. No one on her, so she'll take it. Nice pass up to DeFryer. I'm sorry, Mercer. Mercer makes a shift. Over to Connolly. Low shot. Nice save by Woodward. It's loose in front. Good job by McLaughlin following up that rebound. 4 seconds left in the period. Let's see what they can do. There's plenty of time to win a draw back and take a slap shot. DeFryer on the faceoff. Plenty of time. Okay, well, that's the end of the first period. Melrose looked a little sluggish. They'll start up the second period with a 2-0 lead, and they'll have a 21-second power play going into the period. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back to the Melrose Lady Red Raider girls hockey versus the Bishop Fenwick Lady Crusaders. We're up here at the Peabody Rink to begin the second period. Melrose enjoying a 2-0 lead. Melrose will have a power play for the next 12 seconds. Gorman gets hung up behind the net. We're going to get a penalty on Gorman, maybe an elbow, a high stick. I'm going to keep that elbow down a little bit. I'm going to get a cross check. So now we'll have the 5-second 4-on-4. And then Bishop Fenwick will go on the advantage. Courtney O'Connor, number one in net. Jill Mercer with the puck around the net. Trying to get the puck out. Chelsea can't get it out. Mercer will. Minute and 15 seconds. Bishop Fenwick will go on the power play. Perry steps up. Mercer comes over, makes me get rid of it. Katie Perry on the puck, battling around the boards. It was a nice centering pass. The hatchet waves at it. Good job by Mercer intercepting that pass. The hatchet's on it. Can't get it out. Got to keep your stick on the ice. That's where the puck is. Chelsea Kelly, good job on that one-man forecheck. Here comes the hatchet. No icing. Bishop Fenwick player touched it. Katie Perry on the puck, up off the glass, is able to not angle it out, but gets a stick in the body there, which is what you want to see. Chelsea Kelly's able to dump that deep. 18 seconds to go on the Melrose penalty to Alyssa, don't call me Haley Gorman. Connolly on the puck. Intercepted by Crone. Back to Connolly. Didn't connect. Crone backhands that down. Muggsy Connolly on the puck. Stick checking. Can't get to it. That Cockaludo comes around. Crone says, introduces herself, says, hello. My name's Sammy. Connolly on the puck behind the net. Centers it. Crone can't put the stick on it. Dobby pinches in. Here's the Fryer. She'll angle it back to nobody. She'll keep it. Drops a pass to Sammy. Sammy dumps it down deep. Connolly alone in front of the net for the moment. Connolly comes in. Kicks it to Crone. Can't connect. Oh, sniper. Sniper. We got an icing here on Bishop Fenwick. Got a face off in the offensive zone. Alyssa, don't call me Haley Gorman out there with Dobby. It's nice to be Rich. Chelsea Kelly on the face off. Rich to Gorman. Wisely puts it in the corner. Is Julia McLaughlin along with Kelsey. Chelsea Kelly, who falls down, was hacked. Rich sends it towards the net. Gorman one-on-one. She makes the player get rid of the puck. Got to take the body on that. Good job by Rich coming down. There's an outlet pass from Sikora to McLaughlin. Gets caught from behind. 2-on-1 for the moment. Rich in the passing lane. Hacksaw gets back. Backhands it. We're going to get a penalty. Hacksaw's on the ice. She'll get up. She's a tough kid. She's got Everett roots in her. Melrose will go on the power play. 11:30 in the period to go in the period. 2-0 lead. No lead safe in hockey, especially a 2-goal lead. They say it's the worst lead in hockey. Faceoff will be all the way down in the offensive zone for Melrose. Melrose has Smiley DeFraya, Julia McLaughlin, Muggsy Connolly, Jill Mercer, and Sammy Crone out there. See if they can really get a good power play going here. Move this puck around. Move it when they want to move it, not when they're forced to move it. And don't just take a shot just because you have a shot. DeFraya wins the puck. McLaughlin angles it back in. Bishop Fenwick able to clear that puck out. There's Mercer. Move the puck, Jill. Move the puck. Move the puck. No sense hanging on to it. Move the puck. Makes a nice pass to Connolly. Connolly makes a nice shot into the skate. Makes a shift. Gets over the line. She'll control it. Drop it back to Mercer. Mercer to DeFraya. DeFraya's looking for someone open. Finds Connolly across ice. Nice play by Connolly, not shooting it. Here's Mercer, has the shot. Now you take it. Connolly tries to get it in, can't. Sorry in the camera work there. I got Shaky McGillicuddy working the camera for me today. Good job by Melrose keeping this puck in. 30 seconds to go on the Melrose power play, and we're going to get a puck out of the ice surface. Now it's back in. Pucks from heaven. Let's see what the Fryer can do here. Bishop Fenwick wins the puck, wins control. Connolly keeps it in. Bouncing puck, stays in the zone. Melrose doing a good job. There's Connolly on the puck. She stops, look to make a pass. Back to Mercer. Mercer makes a move. Makes another move. Let's pass that puck. Good job back to DeFryer. Nice cross-ice pass to McLaughlin. Can't pull the trigger. There's Crone in front. Get rid of the puck. You got a girl coming out of the box. There's McLaughlin on the puck. Bishop Fenwick able to get it out. DeFryer on the puck here. She'll wind this up. Bishop Fenwick's going to be tired. Nice pass to Crone, who'll dump it, and Melrose will get a change. 9:27 to go. It was a pretty anemic power play from Melrose. Here's Gorman carrying the puck into the zone. Going to the backhand, going to the net. And we're going to get a goal. Good job by Gorman pushing that in. She looks like she followed up her rebound and was able to bang it home. Melrose is up 3-0 now. With 9:11 to go, Melrose will take a 3-0 lead. Like I said, folks, that's what you have to do with Woodward. She's a seasoned goalie. Comes from a long line of goalies. Her uncle Pat over in Everett. Another girl with Everett roots. These are tough kids here. There's Gorman on the puck. She brings it across the blue line. They're giving her the shot. She's going to take it. There's a nice save, and Kendall can't put the stick on the puck. Good job by Gorman getting back. She'll backhand it over to Rich. Rich makes a move. Looks like Bobby Orr there. Keeps the puck. They're giving it to her. She's going to take it. Keep your head up. It's nice to see the defensemen make a shift out of the zone. But at that point, if they have someone up ice, they really should be getting them the puck. Grace Secor coming out to join the action along with Maggie Doyle and Mairead Clack. 8:25 to go in the second period. Melrose enjoying a 3-0 lead. Katie Perry's able to keep it in. Cross ice pass. Nice pass to the Bishop Fenwick player. Mercer does a good job stepping over. There's Grace to Clack, who makes a nice shift move on the defensive player. Bishop Fenwick dumps it back in. NTKP on the puck, overskates it. She'll move it around, angle it off the boards to Mercer. Mercer will take a look and break it out. Skates right into the Bishop Fenwick player, trips her, but gets the puck back. Perry up the boards to Clack. Clacky can't move it out. Bishop Fenwick's able to keep it in. Allie Charette on the puck. Backhander in front of the net. And Madeline Williams out there, another sophomore. Let's ice this puck, girls. Come on, Jill, you know what to do. Ice the puck. Makes a shift, keeps it on her stick, puts it towards the net. No one there for a rebound. Forwards have to get up ice, crash that net. That's how we're scoring the goals today. DeFryer on Cockaludo. There'll be no icing on that. Dobby Rich on the puck. Wisely stops and goes to the forehand. Here's Clocky on the On the puck, there's a race. Cockaloodle wins it. Muggsy Connolly makes sure to get rid of it. There's a bad bounce off the ref. Melrose is all tagged up. Nice job by Rich. Going to get an offsides. Good job by Rich. She was going to use the body if the puck got by her. But the puck didn't get by her. That's what you want to see. Strong on the puck. Smiley wins it back to Darby. It's nice to be Rich. Darby tries to move it up the boards. Here's the Fryer on the puck. Good job by Rich getting back into it. Here's Muggsy helping out. Got to jump on that puck. Jump on that puck, Courtney. Here's Crone breaking it out. We've got a penalty on Bishop Fenwick for that one. Going to get a trip on Dottolo, our senior. It's her second penalty. Coach going with Chelsea Kelly at center, who wins it back to Gorman. Perry to Gorman. Takes a nice high shot, misses the net. Emma Sikora out there with Darby Rich. Nice pass over to Chelsea Kelly, back to Gorman. It's a bouncing puck, couldn't get good wood on it. Rich using that body and back behind the net, good job. Here comes the hacksaw. She's not going to like that. Perry to Gorman. Perry keeps it in. Back to Perry. Take that shot, Katie. Nice high shot. Nice glove save by Woodward. Melrose doing a good job of crashing the net. That's what you have to do. That's where you're going to score on the rebounds. 54 seconds to go on the Melrose penalty. 5:21 to go in the second period. Face-off win by Kelly to Perry. To Gorman. Gorman takes a shot. Doesn't make it through. Perry hustles in and keeps it in. Here comes Rich coming off the out of the corner with it. Looks to make a pass. Does to Kelly. Nice cross-ice pass to Perry. Shot down low. Is a bouncing puck. Loose puck in front. Good puck movement there. That was excellent. Instead of just shooting it for the sake of shooting it, they got a nice shot by Perry. Had an open lane to the net. And there were rebounders in front. 32 seconds to go. Smiley DeFryer out there with McLaughlin, Connolly, Mercer, and Crone. Have to watch that girl coming out of the box. Connolly to Mercer. It was a nice face-off win by... Here's a screenshot. Good job in front. Good job by number 11, Megan Carney, the junior talented skater for Bishop Fenwick. DeFryer's winning a lot of face-offs. There's another one. There's Mercer on the puck. She'll control it. Over to Connolly. Connolly lets loose a slap shot. Makes its way through. Woodward makes a save. There's DeFryer coming out. Nice pass to Connolly. Over to Mercer. Backhand it can't get to DeFryer. And that should end the penalty. Mercer on the puck. 2 seconds to go on the penalty. All even now. Move the puck, Jill. Nice pass up to Sammy. Nice job by number 11. Good body contact there. If you don't like it, buy a racket. Buy a tennis racket. Nice pickpocket job there by Melrose. There's Mercer on the puck. You have McLaughlin wide open on the right. Why go up where everybody is? Here comes Connolly in. Stick checks. Nice angled pass from DeFryer to Crone. To McLaughlin. Nice shift by McLaughlin. She gets it to the net. Woodward makes the save. That's better passing there. Again, the defense has to make better passes, quicker passes, smarter passes. They're going to be going into the tournament soon enough, and that's going to be a big, big factor. how the defense plays for Melrose. Dobby, it's nice to be rich on defense, along with Alyssa, don't call me Haley Gorman. Michelle Henry out there, along with Emma Penault and Kellyanne Kendall. Gorman on the puck, circles it around the net, stops, cuts up ice. Nice pass to Penault, touch pass to Henry. Henry's able to get that deep, no icing. That's a good play. Get over the red line, dump it deep, and go chase it. Dobby can't keep it in. There's a foot race. Come on, Alyssa. Keep that on your forehand, Alyssa. Take it a little into the zone and circle right around and get it out. Don't like to see backhanders when you're going forward. You got to anticipate that the other team's going to have one on you and another one in support. And so when you weakly backhand it up the boards, you're backhanding it into two of their players. Keep it on your forehand. Get to open ice. Ref says play it. Courtney dumps it into the corner. Mercer can't get it around. And again, another weak backhander. It's Kellyanne Kendall on the, I'm sorry, Grace Sikora on the puck. Nice pass to Bishop Fenwick player. There's Maggie, I'm sorry, Mairead Clark. You have to gain that line, Mairead. Girls, very simple. Get it out of the zone and then get it. Nice job by number 11. Good job by Mercer to recover. And Megan Condy's a player for them. There's Kelly Stanton out there getting some action. Perry pinches in. Bishop Fenwick breaks it out. There's Clarkie on the puck. She gets hooked. Perry takes it, breaks it out. Nice shift at the blue line. She's going to beat number 15. She's going to try to skate through everybody. Can't. Comes Muggsy Connolly out with Gorman. Nice shift. It was a nice shift by 21. Their sophomore defenseman, Lauren Coccoluto. She was able to get it in the short side. Courtney has to squeeze that side post. Good job by Gorman. Connolly back to DeFryer, gets knocked over. She'll get her number. Here comes Kroon breaking through. Collects the puck. Nice play by the Bishop Fenwick player, number 10. There's a shift by Rachel. She'll break it out. Don't understand that one, Rachel. You have two forwards all alone up there. You got to pass the puck. Nice save by Courtney. Dumps it into the corner. Don't understand this idea of carrying the puck from end to end. There you go. Pass the puck. It's Sammy Krohn coming up ice. Rich keeps it in. Good job by Dobby. Fighting hard to keep that puck in. Julia McLaughlin enters the fray. Gorman whiffs on the shot to keep it in. Nice pass by Rachel to Bishop Fenwick player. Feeling very charitable here today, Melrose. A lot of nice passes to the opponent. We're going to get a penalty on that one. Come on, keep blowing. That'll end the period. Bishop Fenwick will start off with a power play. Melrose enjoys a two-goal lead, but as we know, it's the worst lead in hockey. We'll be back in just a moment to start the third period. Hello and welcome back to the Melrose High Lady Red Raiders varsity hockey versus the Bishop Fenwick Lady Crusaders. Start of the third period, Melrose enjoying a 3-1 lead. For the next minute and a half, they're going to have to kill a penalty. Katie Perry dumping that in deep. One on the forecheck, that's Sammy Krohn. We have Muggsy Connolly out there along with Jill Mercer. Good job by Sammy breaking that up. Here's Connolly. Can't intercept it. Mercer comes over. Nice play by Bishop Fenwick, getting that to the point. Crone will break that out. She's got Connolly. Okay. Sammy loses her feet. Gets back up. We're going to get a penalty on Sammy. Are you kidding me? She got knocked down. She got knocked down before. If they call the first penalty, there won't be the second penalty. But for 42 seconds, it'll be 5-on-3. Julie McLaughlin out there with Jill Mercer and Katie Perry. Melrose wins the draw. Mercer couldn't control it, so she'll take it around. She gets broken up. Melrose will stay in the triangle to defend this. Perry on the puck. Good job by Mercer in front. They held her stick. No penalty on that. That's what Melrose has to do in front. Just bang these girls. Bang them. Can't give them rebounds. Good job by Mercer in front. Julia can't be chasing that. No need to chase that. Stay in the triangle. We're going to get a penalty on Bishop Fenwick for that. We're going to call them both matching penalties. I don't agree with that. Be a 5-on-4 now for 47 seconds. Smiley DeFryer out there with Chelsea Kelly. NTKP and Alyssa Don't Call Me Haley Gorman. You have Cockaludo out there on defense. Centered by Blanchette, a sophomore. Lexi McNeil's out there. It's a shot towards the net, saved by Courtney. Saved by Woodward. She'll dump that into the corner. Smiley's on her. Comes Cockaludo, gets pickpocketed by Chelsea. Perry steps up. DeFryer gets it in, loses her feet. Cross-ice pass, can't connect. Gorman's on that. Backhands it weakly around, and Perry makes a nice play to get that puck out of the zone. 10 seconds left on the Bishop Fenwick power play. Linnea Chelsea Kelly on the puck. Good job by Linnea. Cross-ice pass. Sammy Kroon poke checks there. Here comes DeFryer. Sure. Prone to DeFryer. Girls don't look like they want to get it into the zone. There we go. Connolly and Crone on the puck. Jaguar is able to get that out. Connolly forechecking. Sammy coming down to help out. That's what they need. Aggressive forecheck. Make them get rid of the puck. Angle that puck up. Got to angle that off the boards. It's a lot easier to pass the handle for the forwards. Melrose on side. Here comes Connolly skating hard into the zone. Gorman pinching in nicely. Come on, take it off the boards, girls. That's it. Kelly gets it deep. Rachel Boylan on that for Bishop Fenwick. Darcy Ridge keeps it in, makes a move. Gets it knocked off her stick, follows up the rebound. Skating hard, playing the whistle. Woodward able to jump on that. Kelly, center, and McLaughlin and Sakura. Mercer and Perry on defense. Nice pass from Sikora to Mercer. Can't get it through. Back to Mercer. Had Perry wide open. It's Kellyanne Kendall. I'm sorry, that was Grace Emma Sikora. Pass from McLaughlin to Mercer. Just blindly shoots it. Got to keep your head up there, Jill. Perry can't keep it in. Nice pass to the Bishop Fenwick player. Is Perry winding it up? She'll dump that down smartly. Hacksaw Sikora on the puck. Keeps it on her stick. Michelle Henry poking it deep. There's Julia McLaughlin on the puck. Perry takes a shot, doesn't make it through. Bouncing puck. A lot of battling going on. Mercer doing a good job of coming down the boards, being strong on the puck. Michelle Henry bringing it around, gets bumped off. Got to be quicker than that. Perry pinching in to keep it in. 10:15 to go in the third period. Melrose up 3-1. Bishop Fenwick breaks it out. He's able to get that puck deep. That's Caitlin Carney, a junior. Can't get caught from behind, girls. This is the problem on defense for Melrose. They don't move the puck effectively. They're just not getting the puck out of the zone properly. They're taking way too long to move the puck. Bobby Orr doesn't play for Melrose. Good job by... That's a good job by Mercer. Takes a shot, a save, followed up. Kellyanne couldn't get her stick on the puck, but the puck was there. And here comes Cocoludo. And nice save by Courtney O'Connor. That's a game saver there. Two-goal lead. DeFryer on the faceoff with Connolly and Crone. Here comes Crone breaking it out. Nice pass to Bishop Fenwick. Here comes Connolly. Makes a move. Makes another move. Can't get it in. Ran out of ice. That was a nice pass by Crone. Nice to see. Good shift by Rachel, keeping it in. Down to Connolly. She'll control it. Angles it up to Rich. Rich sends it towards the net. There's Connolly coming off. Can't get it in. Nice save by Woodward following up that rebound. Good job stick handle here by Melrose. Nice pass in the puck. DeFryer, Connolly, and Crone, three sophomores. Bobby Rich, a freshman. Melissa Gorman, the captain, senior. Rachel wanted that to go to the net. That's the set play there. The two forwards will break to the net. Cocoludo on defense. And Blanchett out there. That's to the net. That's what they wanted. Crone got a piece of it. Keep your feet moving, Sammy. Nice job by Rachel. Using some body contact. Here's Connolly on the puck. Angles it over to Sammy Crone. Nice move by Sammy. Go to the net. Connolly on the puck. She's going to cycle out of the corner with it. Get it over to Gorman. Gorman gets a shot, and it's a goal. Nice job on the screen in front there by DeFryer and Crone. Woodworth never saw it. Didn't have a chance. Nice puck movement there. 8:15 to go in the third. Merrills will take a 4-1 lead. Good job by Alyssa, don't call me Haley, Gorman to get that puck on net. Cocoludo out there along with Allie Jagir. Here's Mercer with the puck. Maggie Doyle out there forward along with Grace Sikora, Linnea Kelly. Katie Perry on the puck. It's another example of the defense not moving the puck out of the zone properly. Melrose has to do a better job, and if the Melrose defense isn't comfortable or confident passing it to the forwards have to get better at getting in position so they can receive that pass. Kelly and Kendall out there with Emma Penault, Michelle Henry. Mercer has the puck. Pass up to Kendall. There's a foot race. Good job by Kellyanne, making her to get rid of it. Good body contact here by the girls. Like to see it, there's a centering pass. Here's Katie Perry over to Mercer. Mercer takes a look. Penault whiffs on the shot. That was a nice look by Jill. She put her head up, took a look. There's a save by Woodward. Michelle tries to turn around, and Melrose plays the whistle. Good job by Melrose being in front of the net, playing that whistle. 6:54 to go in the third. Melrose enjoying a 4-1 lead. Melrose sends out the first line of DeFryer, Crone, and Connolly. Rich and Gorman on defense. Sends it towards the net. Connolly can't get the stick on it. There's a shot from Gorman, doesn't make it through. Rich will carry that down deep. Passes to Connolly in front, tips it, can't get it to the net. Melrose has to play stronger in front of the net. Nice shift by Gorman. Takes a shot. It's loose. And I think Connolly was able to get that in. Good job by Connolly, being strong in front of that net. That's what I was just talking about. That's Connolly's second for the game. Good job by Gorman getting that to the net. She saw she had an open lane, took the shot. Those are two teammates in softball for the Melrose girls varsity softball. There's Crone over to, Dobby Rich. Received the pass from Gorman. Kelly's able to poke that deep. McLaughlin gives chase. Cockaludo does a good job of circling that around. Rich can't keep it in, but she's on the puck. Good job by Rich, stopping and starting. Nice outlet pass to Sakura. Here's the hatchet. That's why they call her the hatchet. She's going to go into the box for a minute and a half. Kids wonder how they get their nicknames, but that's a perfect example of why Emma is the hatchet. They call her brother Trigger on the boys' team because he's a sniper. He pulls the trigger. Kelly Stanton out there trying to kill this penalty for Melrose along with Mairead Clark. Katie Perry on D along with Mercer. Mercer will ice that puck wisely. Remember, no lead is safe in hockey. Clarkey makes her get rid of it. Good job by Clarkey. Stanton can't get it deep. Perry does. Minute left to go on the power play for Bishop Fenwick. It's Olivia Voreus, a senior out there. Here comes their other senior. Dottolo dumps it deep. Mercer cuts in front, can't control it. There's a shot, doesn't get through. Courtney O'Connor's playing a great job in net today. There's a nice block by Perry in front. Let's ice that puck, girls. Let's not fool around with it. Mercer will do that. Thank you, Jill. 20 seconds to go on the Bishop Fenwick power play. There's Michelle Henry on the forecheck, along with Kellyanne Kendall. Sammy Crone playing defense, along with Rachel DeFryer. There's a stick to the head. They're going to let go. Good job battling down there by Michelle Henry. She comes around from behind the net, tries to stuff it in. Sniper by Michelle. Sniper. DeFryer is able to keep that in, dump it down. All even, 4 minutes to go in the period. There's Michelle Henry on the forecheck. She cycles it back down. Kelly and Kendall will win that battle. There we go. goes for a little ride. We're going to get a penalty on the Bishop Fenwick player. I don't know if that was really a penalty. I wouldn't call that at this stage of the game. I think there are some things you have to let go, and that's one of them right there. We have the Hatchet Sakura out there with Chelsea Kelly and Dobby. It's nice to be rich. Alyssa, don't call me Haley Gorman on defense, along with not that Katie Perry. Perry over to Gorman, can't keep it in. Gorman to Perry. Nice cross-ice pass to the Hatchet. Backhand pass to Gorman. Over to Perry. Back to Gorman. Good job of puck movement here. Kelly just shoots that towards the net. Probably not the best choice. Here comes Gorman. She'll stop. Get this set up. Nice pass over to Perry. Now you can take your shot. That was a nice play there. Perry had an open lane. She took a look. Saw where she wanted to go. There were girls in front of the net to bang home a rebound. That's what you want to see on your power play. Good puck movement. Move the puck now. Here's Gorman to Perry. Open ice. She'll take it. Passes it to Linnea Kelly. Linnea back to Gorman. Gorman sees a shot, and there's a save by Gorman. I'm sorry, save by Woodward. Good job in front on defense by Cocoludo and Jaguar. Couple of sophomores, they're not afraid to get physical. Defense, you have Muggsy Connolly, Jill Mercer, forward Sammy Crone, Rachel DeFryer, and Julia McLaughlin. 28 seconds left on the power play. They win it back to Connolly. Connolly takes it deep, controls the puck. Syke comes out, rips off a shot. Nice save by Woodward. I think Connolly's going for that hat trick. Is Connolly coming out with it? I'm sorry, Mercer. Keeps it on her stick, smartly. Keep your head up, Jill. Look to make a pass. Mercer to DeFryer. DeFryer sees Connolly covered. Sees McLaughlin as a one-timer. And DeFryer's going to get a goal. Good job there by Melrose. Good puck movement. Melrose is going to increase their lead 6-1. That's good puck movement there. Nobody panicked. Nobody moved the puck before they should. Nobody shot before they should. Linnea Kelly on the puck. Cycles it back to Rich, who angles that off the boards nicely to Stanton. Here comes Kelly. 2 minutes to go in the game. Good job by Gorman coming over and using that body. Makes a pass up to Clark. Clarky makes a nice move. Dumps the puck deep. Woodward's going to cover that up. Get a faceoff in the offensive zone with 1:45 to go. Linnea Kelly. Mairead Clark. Kelly Stanton. Dobby Rich and Alyssa Gorman. Gorman takes the puck. Down to Clark. Clark backhands it. Melrose able to keep it in. Cycle it down deep. That's what you have to do. Cycle it deep. Good job by Kelly on that back check. Disrupts the puck carrier. Dobby Rich on the puck. She'll take it behind the net. Circle it up. She's going to angle it out. No icing. Good play. Dottolo on the puck. Senior captain, she'll angle it out. Here comes Gorman coming in. She's looking for a hat trick too, I think. Hat tricks are not easy to come by in hockey, so when you have an opportunity, you try to get it. There's a shot down to O'Connor. Ref says play it, so she does. She gets it out. Cocoludo on the puck. Over to Dottolo. Here comes Clarkie. Good job by Clarkie, sacrificing that body. Make her father proud. Cross-ice pass. Broken up by Gorman, who will fire that back in. Here comes Dottolo. DeFryer on the puck. Makes her get rid of it. 33 seconds left. Gray Sikora on the puck. Tries to carry it out. Here comes Doyle. Makes the pass up to Connolly. Connolly keeps it. Cycles around. She wants this hat trick. Takes a slap shot. That's what she's looking for. She's not going to get it. But made a couple of nice moves and a slap shot. DeFryer dumps it down. This Cockaludo on the puck. Good hustle there at the end. A good job by Melrose finishing their season at 12-8. That's a new season high for the Melrose Lady Red Raiders. And we'll be going into the playoffs, so we'll see you there very soon.